cultivation practices of barnyard millet. In this, we are going to look about botanical distribution, importance, origin and history, area and distribution, grain composition, climate and soil requirements, seasons and varieties, field preparation, seed treatment, seed rate, spacing, sowing, germinated seedlings, nutrient management, thinning, irrigation management, weed management, cropping systems, harvesting and threshing, yield, diseases and pests of barnyard millet. Introduction. Scientific name of barnyard millet is Echinocloa frumentis. Kingdom, Plantae, and order is Poales. Family, Poaceae. Genus, Echinocloa, and species, Frumentaceae. The vernacular name is Smalu, Kodisama, Bhagar, Varai. Echinocloa esculenta is the Japanese barnyard millet. Echinocloa crassicalis is a common barnyard grass or cockspur grass, whereas Echinocloa frumentis is an Indian barnyard millet, also known as Sawa millet. Botanical distribution of barnyard millet. It is a herbaceous annual which tillers sparsely. Plant grows up to a height of 60 to 120 cm or 2 meters. It is erect, orgeniculate, ascending, often tufted annual. Clumps are slender to robust. Slender plants are decumbent with the clumps strongly branched and rooting from lower nodes. Stout plants are erect with a few clumps and branching from upper nodes. Roots are fibrous and shallow. Leaves are flat, glabrous or slightly hairy without ligule. The inflorescence is a panicle with densely crowded unawned spikelets. The spikelets are densely packed in 3 to 5 rows. Spikelets are subdivided by two glumes within which there are two florets. Color of the glume varies from white to red. The caryopsis remains enclosed in the lemma and palea. Color of the grain is generally yellow or white. Importance of barnyard millet. It is a grain crop of lesser importance. It is very drought resistant but capable of withstanding waterlogging conditions. Cooked rice, kheer, roti, thin porridge, halwa are made by using barnyard millet. It is generally grown as rain-fed crop. These grains are consumed just like rice. They are also used in making rice puddling. It is frequently used in Egypt as a reclamation crop on lands that are too saline for rice. Grain is mostly eaten by the poor classes, but sometimes it is brewed the beer. It is also used as a feed for cage birds. The straw makes good fodder for cattle. Its green fodder is much released by cattle. It is quickest growing of all millets, maturing in about 45 days if the moisture and temperature are favorable for growth and development. This barnyard millet has good source of protein. It is rich in fiber and low in calories and also low in glycemic index food. It is rich in iron and gluten-free. Origin and history of barnyard millet. Barnyard millet has originated from India. Its history is, there is a mention of barnyard millet in ancient literature of India. It has been cultivated in China for more than 2000 years. Some of the investigators think that barnyard millet probably originated somewhere in Central Asia. It spread from Central Asia to Europe and America. Area and distribution of barnyard millet. It remains as important cereal in tropics and subtropics of India. It is grown in India, China, Japan, Malaysia and East Indies. In China and Japan, it is said to be grown as a substitute crop when the rice crop fails. It is also to some extent in Africa and US. In India, it is grown in Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, AP, Maharashtra and Bihar. It can be grown up to an altitude of 2000 meters in Himalayas. The area under cultivation of barnyard millet is 1.95 lakh hectares. The grain composition of barnyard millet is, the protein percent that is present in barnyard millet is 11.6%. Carbohydrates are 74.3%. Crude fiber are 13.5%, whereas fats are 5.8%, ash 4.5%, and the minerals that are present in barnyard millet are calcium 14 mg, phosphorus 121 mg. Climate and soil requirements of barnyard millet. The climatic requirements are warm and moderately humid climate is good for raising barnyard millet crop. It is a hardy crop and is able to withstand adverse conditions of weather better than other cereals. The soil of barnyard millet is of marginal fertility. It can be grown in partially waterlogged soils such as lowlands, on the banks of rivers, etc. Grows better in sandy loam to loam soils. Gravelly and stony soils with poor fertile are not suitable for raising barnyard millet. Seasons and varieties. The seasons for raising barnyard millet are: in the rain-fed barnyard millet crop can be raised from September to October, whereas the irrigated crop can be raised from February to March. The varieties which are cultivated in different areas of India are: in Uttarakhand, VL172, VL207, PRJ1, VL29 are cultivated. In Uttar Pradesh, VL172, VL207, Anurag, VL29 are cultivated. In Tamil Nadu, CO1, CO2, VL181 and VL29. In Karnataka, VL172, RA11, VL181. And in Gujarat, Gujarat Banti 1 are cultivated. The field preparation of barnyard millet is: since it is cultivated in very light and marginal soils, the land is given only a limited preparatory cultivation. Two ploughings with local plough or harrowing followed by planking are sufficient to prepare the seed bed for barnyard millet. Seed treatment. The seeds are treated with Therum or Sericen at the rate 2.5 grams per kg of seeds and soaking seeds in hot water at 55 degrees Celsius for 7 to 12 minutes to control smut. Seeds and sowing. The seed rate that is considered for barnyard millet is 8 to 10 kg per hectare for line sowing and 12 to 15 kg per hectare for broadcasting. The spacing that is adopted for barnyard millet is 25 cm between rows and 10 cm between the plants. The sowing operation carried out is as follows. Barnyard millet can be sown in the first fortnight of July with the onset of first monsoon rains. The seed is broadcasted or drilled in furrows 3 to 4 cm deep at rate of 8 to 10 kg per hectare. Nutrient management of barnyard millet. Farmyard manure of compost at the rate 5 to 10 tons per hectare should be added for boosting the yield. It is done during field preparation. The nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium are recommended as 44:22:50 kg per hectare. The fertilizer 44 kg of nitrogen, 22 kg of P2O5 and 50 kg of K2O per hectare are recommended as basal application. If irrigation facilities are available, half of the nitrogen should be top dressed in standing crop after 25 to 30 days after sowing. The biofertilizers are inoculating seeds with Agrobacterium radiobacter and Aspergillus avormae. Thinning and gap filling are considered to be the major intercultural operations that are followed in barnyard millet. The word thinning means removal of excess plants in the place where we can see, and the word gap filling is the plants which are removed are transplanted into the place where the seeds are not germinated. Irrigation management. Generally, barnyard millet does not require any irrigation. However, if dry spell prevails for a long time, then one irrigation must be given at the time of panicle initiation. It is always better if excess water of heavy rains is drained out of the field. Irrigation. Irrigating the plot at the critical stages, that is panicle initiation stage. Weed control. The field should be kept weed free up to 25 to 30 days after sowing. Two weedings are sufficient to control weeds in barnyard millet. Weeding operation carried out The weeding operation is done in vegetative stage, that is on 15th days and on 30th day. Weeding. The weeding operation is carried out with the help of a hand hoe. The cropping system of barnyard millet is, the barnyard millet is cultivated along with the rice bean in 4:1 row ratio in Uttaranchal. Harvesting and threshing of barnyard millet. The crop should be harvested when it is ripe. It is cut from the ground level with the help of sickles and stalked in the field for about a week before threshing. The threshing is done by trampling under the feet of bullocks. The yield of barnyard millet is, the average yield of the grain is 400 to 600 kg per hectare. The yield of the fodder or straw around 1200 kg per hectare. With improved package of practices, it is possible to harvest 10 to 12 quintals of grain per hectare. The diseases of barnyard millet are downy mildew, which is caused by a fungus. At beginning, light yellow bands are seen on the leaves, which in due course of time becomes white. Leaves start drying and in severe infection, ear heads become chaffy. Head smut. It is caused by Ustilago crassgallis. According to Kulkarni, when are mixed with spores and sown, about 90% of plants become infected. In addition, the smut also produces swelling on the stem, the nodes of the young shoots and in the axils of the older leaves. The galls, like swellings, are covered by a hairy rough membrane of host tissue and may be up to 12 mm in diameter. It infects only ovaries. This is extremely seed-borne and occurs late in crop season when the crop is about to mature. Management of head smut. It can be easily controlled by seed treatment with carbendazim or thyrum at rate 2 grams per kg seeds before sowing. The variety PRJ1 is reported to be resistant to this disease. Roughing of infected plants from the field is also helpful in reducing the spread of this disease. Grain smut. The disease is overcularis, but only few grains in an ear are affected. The affected seeds enlarge 2 to 3 times of their normal size and their surface becomes hairy. It occurs at the time of rain formation when temperature ranges from 20 degrees centigrade to 25 degrees centigrade. Management of grain smut. Seed treatment with Dithen M45, MBC and Thyrum controlled the disease. Pre-sowing treatment with either carbendazim or thyrum at 3-2 grams per kg seeds is recommended. Kernel smut. Ustilago paradoxa causing the kernel smut. Only few grains in ear are infected. They are scattered and the affected grains appear as greenish swollen bodies. The sori are 1.5 to 4 to 1.2 mm in size and up to 25 infected grains may occur in a panicle. Management of kernel smut. The disease is seed-borne. It can be controlled by seed treatment with systemic fungicide. Leaf spot or blight. It is caused by Helminthosporium crassgallis. The disease appears as isolated, dark brown, scattered and spindle-shaped spots measuring 0.5 to 3 mm, 0.25 to 1.5 mm on flag leaves. Afterwards, they cover entire leaves which becomes grey and dried up. The management of leaf spot or blight. Primary infection comes from the seed-borne inoculum. Seed treatment with systemic fungicide before sowing helps in disease control. Even spraying of copper fungicides at the rate of 0.3% helps in disease control. Leaf blast. It is caused by fungal pathogen Magnaporthy grisea. The symptoms in form of spindle to circular shaped spots and of different sizes appear on the young seedlings. In beginning, the isolated spots have yellowish margin and grayish center. Later, the center becomes ash-colored. Management of leaf blast. Seed treatment with thyrum or carbendazim at the rate 2 grams per kg seeds 24 hours before sowing is effective. Pests of barnyard millet. There are more than 80 species of insect pests recorded on barnyard millet. Root-feeding white grubs, Holotrycha species, Anomala species, and Apogonia species are important in India. Shoot fly, Falaketa causes considerable damage to the seedlings, and the other species, Pula, Simplex, Socata, Oryza, also sometimes occurs on barnyard millet in India. Damage causes production of dead heart. The armyworm separata feeds on seedlings. The thrips feed on leaves of seedlings by scraping the green matter and thereby produces silvery whitish patches on leaves. Stem borer, inference, etc. infects the crop in Asia and Africa. Leafhopper and plant important sucking pests. Grasshoppers feed on leaves and defoliate. The leaf caterpillar is also occasionally present. The bugs infect the developing grains.